Hello everyone, and welcome to my The Young and the Restless official channel. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day. Before we begin, please hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. Tucker informed Billy in the jazz club bar that Jack's gift to Ashley rendered the plan for Jabod unnecessary. Billy asserted that it didn't appear like Jack's gift was sufficient. Tucker claimed that Ashley had received her fair share and that continuing the altercation with Jack was pointless. Billy informed Tucker that nothing had changed because Diane would do whatever it took to gain at least one board seat and had no idea how to manage Jabot. He insisted that there was still a danger to his father's legacy. Tucker observed that because Jack insisted on making disastrous errors with Diane, Ashley had come to the realization that it was pointless to argue with him. Billy asserted that he did not think Ashley was unconcerned with preserving John's legacy. Tucker claimed to have noticed Billy's interest in managing Jabot independently and his concern that he had lost his opportunity. The war with Jack, according to Tucker and Ashley, was not worth it. Billy reminded Tucker that Ashley had previously been driven to demonstrate that, given the chance, Diane would completely destroy Jabot. He questioned whether Tucker was suggesting that Ashley had lost interest because Jack had given her a share in the business. Billy claimed that because of how much Jabot meant to her, he did not believe it. Because Tucker didn't want him to be a part of the plan, he claimed that Tucker was attempting to ice him out. Because of what Billy was prepared to do to his family, Tucker claimed he was unreliable. Billy claimed Ashley was similarly affected. Billy informed Tucker that he and Ashley had concurred that Diane was a threat and that Jabot would suffer as long as Jack kept making foolish choices. Tucker questioned Billy's decision not to approach Jack, but Billy responded that it would be extremely risky for Jabot. Billy urged that Tucker take every precaution to keep Ashley safe and make things right. Billy had thought, according to Tucker, that he would be better qualified to run Jabot and enjoy complete autonomy. Billy pledged to take whatever action was necessary to restore the equilibrium. Billy was instructed by Tucker to find a way to overthrow Diane. Tucker departed. Nate informed Victor at the ranch that he believed SNA's early plans lacked cohesiveness. He claimed that it lacked cohesion and a feeling of a singular vision. Nate claimed that Adam and Nick were at odds over Sally and that Adam was concentrating on trying to merge SNA with Newman Media. Nate claimed that because Sharon and Nick did not share Adam's focus, this had led to tension and instability among them. Victor was asked by Nate if he believed Adam would follow orders. Nate insisted that Adam's behavior and attitude were harmful to SNA's operations. Nate was questioned by Victor if Adam's obsession with Newman Media was to blame. Nate said that as a warning sign for what was to come, he wasn't sure whether Adam could ever let that go. Nate asserted that it was detrimental to the company for Nick and Adam to be at war with one another constantly. Nate questioned Victor about whether he believed Adam would ever get on board to build a profitable and harmonious business rather than another Newman Media obsession in the future. Nate was asked by Victor about Nick. As SNA was a new firm that required a strong leader, Nate claimed Nick was level-headed but preferred to play things safe. Victor questioned what Nate would do to ensure the success of SNA if he were in charge of it. Victor was informed by Nate that the new company's general structure was a concern. Due to the stark differences between each organization, he claimed that the combination of Kirsten McCall had been a misguided merger. He claimed that although Kirsten's platforms were soon becoming outmoded, McCall's media section was developing quickly. He promised to reduce Sharon's business to its bare basics before incorporating the new business into Newman Media. Nate said it was smart business, but Victor might not want to admit it if it meant giving Adam that much of a victory, or he might think it required more time to become stable. Nate predicted that Victor would eventually combine SNA with Newman Media to form a formidable force. Victor informed Nick that Nate was just leaving as he arrived. Victor revealed to Nick that he had consulted Nate about SNA's business idea. Nick questioned Victor about switching Adam out for Nate. If such were the case, Nick asserted that he would not cooperate with Nate. Victoria congratulated Ashley at society and mentioned that she had learned that Ashley and Tucker were launching a new business and that Ashley was quitting Gibbot. She expressed amazement that Ashley had distanced her family in order to make amends with Tucker. Victoria questioned whether Ashley intended to abandon her father's heritage in favor of a cosmetics war, or if this was just the beginning of an effort to steal Gibbot from Jack. Ashley claimed that the decision to separate ways with Jack was a mutual one and that her priorities had changed. Victoria admitted to Ashley that she had a similar intra-family business rivalry since Adam was eyeing Newman Media and she was aware of the potential for upheaval and instability. Ashley questioned Victoria's motives for inquiring about Gibbot and her family. Victoria explained that because Billy was now in a decent place, she was concerned about how the scenario would affect him. She claimed that she didn't believe Billy deserved to be made the center of a business or family conflict. Billy, according to Ashley, was exactly where he desired to be. Ashley acknowledged that Billy was in a good place, and that given Diane's position of power, he would be able to handle any issues that could arise. Victoria questioned Jack's approach to Ashley leaving Gibbot and joining the opposition. Ashley explained to Victoria that since Diane held a prominent position at Gibbot, Jack's primary concern was Diane and that Victoria could not stay. She claimed she was unable to watch Diane hurt the business. Victoria asserted that Ashley wouldn't dissipate and let Diane wreck what John had created. Ashley claimed that despite her best efforts, Jack refused to listen, forcing her to let go. Victoria asserted that nothing Ashley stated was accurate. She questioned Ashley's statement that Billy would overcome impending difficulties. Ashley, who was enraged by Victoria's seeming protectiveness of Billy, questioned why Victoria was bringing up Billy. Victoria claimed that both she and Billy had moved on and were now concentrating on their children. Victoria inquired as to Billy's possible involvement in Ashley's departure from Gibbot. Victoria chuckled as Ashley remarked that Victoria had just told Billy she was letting him go and that they had both moved on. Victoria claimed that they had children together and cared for one another, assuring her that everything was fine. Ashley departed. Adam was about to leave the athletic club when Tucker approached him. Tucker expressed his surprise at Adam's ego being on display in public following his most recent spectacular failure. He claimed that Adam's effort at blackmail had been thwarted by Audra, and Big Dad had busted him. Adam questioned whether Tucker should resume his celebration of tricking Ashley into believing he had changed. Adam claimed that he still had the damaging emails that he could reveal in order to stop Tucker from grinning. Tucker didn't believe Adam would act in such a dumb way since unfavorable press would be bad for the business Adam controlled and would make Nick and Sharon unhappy. Adam assured Tucker that the business would survive, but Tucker disagreed. That would be worthwhile, according to Adam. When Billy came, he inquired as to the situation. Adam claimed Tucker was criticizing him for the manner he decided to manage Tucker's business. Tucker departed. Billy apologized to Adam for all Connor was up to. He expressed his happiness that Connor was receiving assistance, but expressed his inability to fathom Adam's struggle. Billy promised to speak with Chelsea the following day. Billy was allegedly only partially honest, according to Adam, and his true objective was to learn more about Tucker. Billy asserted that he had no understanding what Adam was discussing. He declared that he wasn't working with Tucker because they didn't get along. Adam claimed that he had a suspicion that Billy despised Diane and that the fact that Jack had wed her didn't sit well with Billy. Billy claimed Jack was aware of the family's feelings toward Diane, but had decided to ignore them. Billy asserted that the conflict wasn't worthwhile. Adam questioned whether Jack intended to succeed Billy as co-CEO. Billy responded no, but Adam surmised that Jack had likely considered running Gibbot alongside Diane Abbott. Billy would receive a slap in the face, according to Adam. Billy claimed that Adam believed everyone to be deceitful and that this was how he perceived the world. Adam claimed to be aware of Billy's informational snooping on Tucker. Billy questioned why it was important to Adam. Adam asserted that if someone would do him a favor, he could be willing to sell them information about Tucker that would bring Tucker down a notch. Billy questioned whether the evidence could be so damning. Billy was told where to find Adam if he wanted to discuss the topic again. Adam went. Tucker texted Audra from his club suite. Adam's still a wild card. I want him dealt with. Ashley entered and told Tucker that she'd had an odd talk with Victoria that made her wonder about their future. She claimed she felt she was making the right decision by leaving Jebote, but she had spent months attempting to keep Diane out of her father's business, which was her family. Ashley warned Tucker that if she abandoned the conflict, Billy would be left alone to pressure Diane to the point where the business crumbled. She questioned whether it appeared brutal and as if Diane had assaulted her. She argued that Diane couldn't triumph. Tucker exclaimed in frustration that Diane wouldn't succeed and wouldn't require Ashley or Billy's assistance to fail. Ashley emphasized to him the significance of her father's legacy. She didn't need Jebote or Jack, according to Tucker, who also claimed that they had agreed not to wage a pointless, hopeless war. Ashley informed Tucker that she was leaving her family, but Tucker yelled back that he was also a part of her family. He claimed that her fixation on Jack, Diane, and Jebote had impeded their progress. He claimed that a few days prior, she had expressed a desire to leave. Tucker acknowledged how challenging the circumstances were for her. He expressed his desire for her to put their needs first and let everything else work itself out. Nate entered Victoria's office just in time to hear her leave Billy a message asking to meet the following morning to talk about his family. Nate inquired as to the situation. She claimed that there appeared to be some conflict developing at Jebote and that Billy might become involved. If they ever split up, Nate wondered if Victoria would worry that much about him. She argued that it was hardly the same thing, sounding irate. Given that she had already decided to put her trust in him once more, Nate apologized and stated he didn't want to upset her. Victoria expressed regret for yelling at Nate. She described a strange meeting with Ashley. She claimed that she wanted to go home and take a long, hot bath because the day had been exhausting. Nate extended an invitation to her to join him for dinner first. If his meeting with Victor had anything to do with his upbeat attitude, Victoria questioned. Nate couldn't figure out what Victor was up to, so he wasn't sure if it had been the best or worst encounter. Victor looked genuinely interested in Nate's appraisal of SNA. Victoria was informed by Nate. How he would manage the situation if he were in charge was Victor's question. Victor, according to her, wouldn't have inquired unless he was considering that possibility or had another angle. She asserted that Victor had a plan that involves Nate and that she wouldn't support it since it might prevent Nate from continuing to work for Newman Enterprises. Nate questioned Victoria about her belief that Victor wanted to give him control over SNA. Victoria advised him to set modest goals. Nate would be placed on an equal footing with Nick and Sharon if Victor decided to replace Adam with him, she claimed. Nate said to have a gut impression Victor thought SNA required a capable leader. Victor was not likely to provide it to Nate, according to Victoria. If Victor offered him the sole post, Nate questioned whether she would make an effort to stop the move. Victoria said that she might believe Nate was using her to gain a promotion. Victor explained to Nick at the ranch that nobody was going. He just wanted a different viewpoint. Nate's opinion on SNA was immaterial, so Nick questioned why Victor had questioned him. Nate, according to Victor, had some valid arguments. He claimed that Nate thought Kirsten Incorporated will become outdated in 5 years. Victor was informed by Nick that he and Sharon had a lengthy conversation about that. He claimed that it was unimportant, because they were willing to update anything that was out of date. Nick questioned why Victor had approached Nate rather than him or Sharon with the business plan. Nick's hostility toward Nate, according to Victor, was impairing his judgment. Nick asserted Victor was engaging in additional behavior. He inquired as to whether it was Adam or Victor who was critiquing Nick or Sharon's work. Victor acknowledged that Nate's judgment was accurate and that he agreed with it. Nick admitted that Nate was a good player, but he cautioned Victor not to be fooled by his financial acumen, since Nate would do everything to advance his career, including hurt Victoria. Adam arrived immediately after Sharon. They'd both inquired as to what was happening. Nick admitted he didn't know, but he had a sneaking suspicion Nate was involved. Victor said he had some fresh ideas and will be making some adjustments to the new business. Victor declared to everyone that he agreed with Adam's proposal to incorporate SNA into Newman Media. Adam claimed that dealing with Victor was never that easy. After all the hell Victor had thrown at him, Adam claimed he didn't think Victor would suddenly change his mind just because Adam said so. He was curious as to what had caused Victor to change his mind. Billy informed Jack when he got to the Abbott residence that he had ran into Tucker. He claimed that it appeared as though Tucker and Ashley were really giving up the battle and surrendering. Billy claimed that while he thought Tucker wanted to go, he didn't think Ashley did since the family business was too significant to her. Jack said to Billy that he questioned whether that was just another distraction to calm them down before the next assault. Billy concurred that he sensed the arrival of something more. Billy claimed he also noticed some tension between Tucker and Adam. Billy claimed that Adam had acknowledged to having negative information on Tucker that Tucker wished to keep private. Adam, according to him, intended to exchange that knowledge for anything. Billy was asked by Jack what Adam had desired. Billy said he didn't know and thought Adam was joking around. Billy expressed worry that he wouldn't be able to speak with Ashley and Tucker to get any information because the door had been banged shut. Billy claimed that the instant Jack gave Ashley her share of the business, it threw the game out of balance. According to Jack, it might have stopped everything. He claimed Ashley had desired it, and now that she had it, they could put an end to the nasty conflict. Billy agreed grudgingly. Jack questioned Billy as to why he didn't appear relieved that they wouldn't be fighting that conflict any longer. So what do you guys think about this update? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like my videos, please press like and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys next time.